In part 6 of our lesson on the inverse circular functions, we will do applications of the inverse functions. In this example, we have to find the exact value of each. This first problem, we have to find the tangent of the cosine inverse of 1/3. Now remember that what comes out of an inverse function is an angle. So what this problem is really asking us to do is find the tangent of an angle, theta. Now let's think about what we know about theta. If theta is the cosine inverse of 1/3, then that means that the cosine of theta equals 1/3. And we could actually draw a picture describing that. Here's theta. If the cosine is 1/3, we know the x value is 1, r has to be 3, which means y is going to equal the square root of 3 squared minus 1 squared, which equals the square root of 9 minus 1, which is the square root of 8, which we know is radical 4 times radical 2, which simplifies to 2 radical 2. Now let's take that and put it on our picture. So finding the tangent of the cosine inverse of 1/3, we do this temporary substitution where we say, well, let's just call this theta. Now let's use our picture. We can find the tangent of theta very easily. We know that that would be the y value, which is 2 rad 2, divided by the x value, which is 1, so this is 2 radical 2. In this next problem, we have to find the sine of 2 times the tangent inverse of 3/4. So remember that the tangent inverse is just going to output an angle, and we can call it theta. So this problem is asking us to find the sine of 2 times theta. Now if theta is the tangent inverse of 3/4, then that means that the tangent of theta is equal to 3/4, and we can draw that picture. Here's theta. We know that tangent is the y value, 3, divided by x, which is 4. R is going to be the square root of the x value, 4 squared, plus the y value, 3 squared, which is the square root of 16 plus 9, which is radical 25, which is 5. So we can take that value for r and put it on our picture. So finding the sine of 2 times tangent inverse of 3/4, we get to substitute that with the sine of 2 theta. Now we have an identity for that. We know this is equal to 2 times sine theta cosine theta, which equals 2. Now we have to find the sine of theta from our picture. We know that sine is the y value, which is 3, divided by r, which is 5. We have to multiply that times the cosine of theta, which is the x value, 4, divided by r, 5. We know that our denominator will be 5 times 5, which is 25. The numerator will be 2 times 3, which is 6, times 4, 24. In this next problem, we have to find the cosine of the quantity sine inverse of 12 thirteenths plus tangent inverse of radical 21 over 2. Now, we're going to simplify this by making substitutions, as we've done now. For sine inverse of 12 over 13, we can call that theta if we want to. And then we know if theta is the sine inverse of 12 over 13, then that means the sine of theta has to equal 12 over 13. And we can draw that picture. Here's theta. The y value has to be 12. R has to be 13. We know that means x is going to be the square root of 13 squared minus 12 squared, because we're doing r squared minus y squared. We get the square root of 169 minus 144. Subtracting, we get radical 25, which is 5. So we can take that, put it up on our picture. We also have this tangent inverse of radical 21 over 2, and that is also going to output an angle, but it is a different angle. It's not theta, so we need to call it something else. It doesn't matter what we call it. We can call it alpha if we want to. Now, if alpha is the tangent inverse of radical 21 over 2, then that means that the tangent of alpha has to equal radical 21 divided by 2, and we can draw that picture. Here's alpha. Tangent is the y value, so radical 21 for y, divided by x. 2 goes in for x. We know that r is going to be the square root of x squared plus y squared, so we have 2 squared plus radical 21 squared. This is equal to the square root of 4 plus 21, which is radical 25, which is 5. So we can get that on the picture of alpha. Now let's come back to the original expression here, and we can make this substitution where we say this is just the cosine of theta plus alpha. And now we can use our sum identity for cosine. We know this will be cosine of the first, theta, times cosine of the second, alpha, minus sine of the first, theta, sine of the second, alpha. Now we can use our diagrams that we just made. The cosine of theta comes right from the picture here. The x value is 5. R is 13. cosine of alpha comes from its picture, the x value 2 divided by r, which is 5. We have to subtract the sine of theta, which is its y value of 12, divided by r, which is 13. And then we have to multiply that times the sine of alpha, which is its y value, radical 21, divided by r, which is 5. Now, we've done a lot of problems like this. We know that it's best to keep that common denominator, so I'm not going to cancel these 5s here because I want to keep the common denominator going. We know that common denominator is 13 times 5, which is 65. From this first product, we're going to get 10 minus the second product is 12 radical 21. 10 and 12 have a common factor of 2. So we factor out the 2, and we have left inside 5 minus 6 radical 21 divided by 65. In this example, we are being asked to write an expression, and we have to find the sine of the cosine inverse of u divided by radical u squared plus 5. Now, our approach is the same. We can see that the cosine inverse function here is going to output an angle, and we know that the cosine of that angle has to equal u divided by the square root of u squared plus 5. We can draw a picture. Here's theta. We know the cosine gives us the x value, which now has to be u, divided by r, which has to be radical u squared plus 5. So we need to solve for the y value here. We know y is going to be the square root of r squared, so radical u squared plus 5 squared minus x squared, which is u squared. This becomes the square root of, when we take a radical and we square it, we know those two processes will undo each other, and we're left with u squared plus 5. Then we have to subtract u squared. The u squareds are going to cancel out, and we have radical 5. So we can take this, put it up on our picture here. Now, our original expression can be written as sine of theta. We go right to the picture, and we know sine is going to be the y value, which is radical 5, divided by r, which is radical u squared plus 5. We will need to rationalize this, so let's multiply by radical u squared plus 5 over itself. We know that the denominator is going to square this radical, so it will end up being u squared plus 5. In the numerator, remember that when you have a radical times a radical, then you can write them both under the radical together. So this becomes the square root of 5 times u squared plus 5, or radical 5u squared plus 25 over u squared plus 5. Both of these forms of the answer are good. It would depend on whether we want the answer to be factored or multiplied out.